For problem number 7, here I want to work through the problem that says I have a buffer that has a pKa value of 4.3. And it has twice as much salt as it does acid. Okay? And the question is, what is its pH? Well, we remember from the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation, the pH is equal to pKa plus the log of the concentration of the salt. I'll just put as S, divided by the concentration of acid, as you can see here. The pH, therefore, would be equal to the pKa, which is 4.3, plus the log of 2 over 1. And plugging and chugging that, punching it into a calculator, we see that the pH is equal to 4.6. Okay, for problem number 8, we say that we have a buffer, again, and it has a pKa value of 4.3, and it is in a solution with a pH of 4.5, and the question is, what is the ratio of salt to acid? And we go back to our Henderson-Hasselbalch equation to say pH equals pKa plus the log concentration of salt, concentration of acid. And now we know that we have 4.5 is equal to 4.3 plus the log of, I'm just going to put S over A here. And if we take this to this side, we get 0.2 equals the log of S over A. Putting that there. Therefore, 10 to the 0.2 is equal to the concentration of S over A. And that turns out to be equal to a ratio of 1.58. Now, I should note that in each case in these problems, I'm going through and I'm actually punching the things in that you would punch into a calculator. There are no problems I'm going to give you on an exam that's going to require you to do that. So it's important that you learn how to set up the problems, but it's not important that you do the calculator part because that is just trivial as far as I'm concerned. So you will not need a calculator for any of the problems you work in my course. Problem number 9 says that a buffer has 3 times as much salt as acid, and the pH of the solution is equal to 9.1. So the question there is, what's the pKa value? Well, to do this, we, of course, go back to our favorite equation, pH equals pKa plus the log salt over acid, and we plug in the numbers, say that 9.1 is equal to the pKa plus the log, in this case, 3 over 1, so that 9.1 minus the log of 3 over 1 is equal to the pKa, which is the value that we're looking for, and we plug that into the equation, we discover that 8.62 is equal to the value of the pKa. Okay, so problem number 10 is a little bit more involved. It says I have 1 liter of an acetic acid buffer at a concentration of 1 molar, which is 1 mole per liter. And the pKa value for this buffer is equal to 4.76. And it's at maximum buffering capacity. Well, now we remember that maximum buffering capacity, we have equal amounts of salt and acid. When you hear maximum buffering capacity, I want you to immediately think 2 things. Salt equals acid, pH equals pKa. So I have a maximum buffering capacity. All right. And it says after add 0.1 moles of HCl All right. With no volume change, what is the pH? All right. So how do we work that problem? Well, first of all, we have to remember that buffer is equal to salt plus acid. How much salt and how much acid do I have? Well, up here, how much buffer I had was I had 1 mole per liter times 1 liter. Therefore, I had 1 mole of buffer. That means I have 1 mole equals salt plus acid. And since salt equals acid, I therefore have salt equals acid equals 0.5 moles of each of them. Now, if I add 0.1 moles of HCl, what happens? Well, let's go back to our equation. Remember that HA goes to H plus plus A minus. I know I'm starting with 0.5 moles of this and 0.5 moles of this, and I'm adding 0.1 moles of protons. But what happens if I put in 0.1 moles here? Does it just sit there? Well, it doesn't, because this is a system that responds to the changes in concentration of protons. If I put protons into this solution, these protons are going to be gobbled up by the A minus to resist that change. That's really important. So if I add 0.1 moles of protons, what I'm going to see is that this is going to disappear by 0.1 moles, and this is going to increase by 0.1 moles. So after I've done that, I will have 0.6 moles and 0.4 moles. Notice I still have 1 mole of buffer. Okay? Now, that then becomes the way that we solve our problem, because now with Henderson-Hasselbalch, we see that pH is equal to the pKa value, which I said was 4.76, plus the log of the new quantities I have of salt and acid, the salt being 0.4, the salt being 0.4 and the acid being 0.6. And again, without a calculator, that's exactly what the solution would be. If you punch it into a calculator, what you will see is that the pH is equal to 4.58. Now, you can see the pH changed only marginally, going from 4.76 to 4.58, despite the fact that I added 0.1 moles of protons. If I had added 0.1 moles of protons to a solution of water, it would have created a solution that would have a pH of 1. So if I start with a pH of 7 and I went to a pH of 1, you can see that that was 6 pH units that changed if there was no buffer. On the other hand, in the presence of this buffer, the pH only changed by 0.18 units. The buffer is resisting changes in pH. So in problem 11, we learn another principle, and that is what happens when we add a strong base to a solution that's a buffer instead of adding a strong acid. So let's go through and look at that. In this case, we're not pursuing what is the pH value, but we're simply asking what is the ratio of salt to acid that happens after we've added this strong base. So let's take a look at the problem. To start the problem, we say that we have 1 liter of a buffer. I don't say what buffer we've got, but we do know that it's at a concentration of 0.6 moles per liter, and it's at maximum buffering capacity, okay, as we had before, and we add 0.1 moles of NaOH. Well, if we do that, then what happens? Well, something's going to happen different than if we added the strong acid, which we did in the last problem, which was HCl. NaOH is a strong base, and so if I add 0.1 moles of that, I will get 0.1 moles of OH minus, when it goes into solution because it completely dissociates. Well, what happens with that? Well, what happens comes back to our equation here. If you remember that HA goes to H plus plus A minus, and if we add a base to it, what happens? Well, the base in this case is hydroxide ions. Hydroxide ions will gobble up these protons. And when they gobble up the protons, the weak acid will release protons to try to replace the ones that were lost right here. Well, what effect does this have? It means that when we add a strong base, hydroxide ions, we will lose one HA for every hydroxide that we add, and we will gain one A minus for each hydroxide that we add. Well, in practical terms, what does that mean? Well, if we look at the original buffer solution, how much buffer did we have? Well, we had 0.6 moles per liter times 1 liter. That meant that we had 0.6 moles of buffer. And we remember that buffer is equal to salt plus acid. And in this case, salt and acid are in equal concentrations because we have maximum buffering capacity. So therefore, 0.6 moles equals salt plus acid. Therefore, salt equals acid equals 0.3 moles. So that means we're starting over here with 0.3 moles of HA and 0.3 moles of A minus. If we add 0.1 moles of hydroxide, we're going to lose 0.1 moles of HA and end up with 0.2. And we're going to gain 0.1 moles of A minus to end up with 0.4. So the ratio of salt to acid that we end up with in this solution would be equal to 0.4 all over 0.2, and that is S over A. We've solved what we've been asked to solve in the problem. Now, if we were plugging that into Henderson-Hasselbalch, if we knew the pKa value, we would simply say that the pH would be equal to the pKa. Let's say we had acetic acid, it would be 4.76 plus the log of 0.4 all over 0.2. But we're not going to do that because we were only asked this ratio right here. This ratio, you notice, is exactly 2:1. Okay, so we have another problem here. That's another variant on these buffer type problems, but this one throws a little bit of a curveball. This is problem number 12. It says that I have 1 liter of a buffer. Doesn't say what buffer, and it's at 0.8 moles per liter of concentration. And it's at maximum buffering capacity, as we've seen all of these so far. So we remember, of course, that salt equals acid. And it says to this solution you add 0.6 moles of salt. We're not adding either strong acid or strong base, we're actually adding salt. It says, what is the new S over A? All right. Well, to do this, of course, we have to first of all know how many moles of buffer that we have, and we have 1 liter times 0.8 moles per liter, and that's equal to 0.8 moles of buffer. And since 0.8 equals salt plus acid, salt equals acid in maximum buffering capacity equals 0.4 moles. So for our equation, HA goes to H plus plus A minus, we're starting with 0.4 of this and 0.4 of this. Now it says I add 0.6 moles of salt. Well, what happens if I add salt instead of adding protons or adding hydroxides? Well, one of the things that students tend to want to do with this is they'll say, oh, well, you have to add or subtract these to switch them back and forth. And that's not really thinking about what's happening in this equation. You'll notice that if I look at this equation, what do I have? I have acid, I have salt, okay? If I add salt, what's going to happen in the equation? Basically nothing. The salt is going to accumulate. So if I add 0.6 moles of this, I'm going to end up with 1.0 moles of salt, and I'm going to have the same amount of acid that I had here, 0.4 moles of acid. So the ratio of salt to acid that I will have is equal to 1.0 divided by 0.4. That's the ratio. That turns out to be equal to 2.5. Okay? So don't be confused. Don't fall into the trap of thinking that this equation automatically goes back and forth. It really only goes back and forth depending upon what we do to the protons. If we add protons, we drive the equation to the left. If we take protons away by adding a strong base, we move the equation to the right. Okay, and the last of the buffer problems, I want to look at yet another variant on these type of problems. It says, first of all, that I have a buffer that has 0.4 moles of salt, and it has 0.2 moles of acid. And it says, how much HCl or NaOH would I have to add to get to maximum buffering capacity? All right. Now, this is a little bit different thing than we've had before. First of all, we can look at this and we see, well, we're not at maximum buffering capacity because we have more salt than we have acid. If we look in this buffer, how many moles of buffer do we have? Well, remember that buffer is equal to salt plus acid. So the moles of buffer that I have is equal to 0.4 plus 0.2 equals 0.6 moles, I can't write very well, of buffer. Okay? Now, so I know the total amount of moles of buffer that I have. At maximum buffering capacity, how many moles of salt and acid will I have? Well, at maximum buffering capacity, under this condition, salt equals acid, and that's equal to 0.3 because the two are going to add up to 0.6. So that means I've got to go from 0.4 moles of salt and 0.2 moles of acid to 0.3 moles of each of those. Now, how do I do that? Well, I either have to add a strong acid or a strong base according to the problem. And the first thing I have to decide is, what am I adding? Am I adding the strong acid or am I adding the strong base? Well, I have to convert salt. I have to reduce the amount of salt that I have and I have to increase the amount of acid. So not surprisingly, if I go back to my equation, HA goes to H plus plus A minus, and I start out with 0.2 of this and 0.4 of this, I need to drive that equation that way, which means I need to put in protons. To put in protons, I have to add HCl. And what's the amount of HCl that I have to add? Well, I have to go from 0.2 up to 0.3, and so that's a difference of 0.1, and that's actually the number of moles of HCl I have to add. If I add 0.1 moles of HCl to that, I will end up with 0.3, and I will end up with 0.3.